Lesson 6.9, radian and trig equations level 2. These are called level 2 because you'll notice that inside the trig function, there's going to be a b value. And thinking back to graphing trig functions, when we had a b value, that changes the period or the cycle of the function. So these take kind of an extra step. And because of that, then the period changes or where they want you to find the x values changes. So on number one, we're trying to still solve for x. We're trying to find the angles, all the angles that fall inside this range here. So to get the sine function by itself, we want to divide by 2 on each side. And so I'm saying sine of 4 times some angle will give me square root of 3 over 2. Let's ignore the 4 for a minute, and let's just say sine of some angle needs to equal square root of 3 over 2. So you might know that off the top of your head. If you don't, you could get your little unit circle out. And so where is the y value? Positive square root of 3 over 2. Well, that's a 60 degree. So it'd be at 60 and 120. But remember, we're doing this in terms of the radians with pi. And so that would be at pi over 3 and 2 pi over 3. So let's just take pi over 3, for instance. This would be a true statement. And so what I'm trying to do, though, is actually solve for x. So we want to use algebra to make an equation to say, okay, 4 times something needs to make pi over 3. It's almost like doing a substitution where we're going to replace these or set these equal to each other to solve. And so I'll put 4 times something equals pi over 3. Okay, I'll go ahead and set up the other one because we said that it's also at 2 pi over 3. So 4 times a number needs to equal 2 pi over 3. Okay, and so then I will solve for x by dividing by 4, but since this is already fraction, I would rather multiply by 1/4 on each side. Multiply straight across, and that gets pi over 12. Same thing over here, multiply by 1/4 instead of dividing by 4, and I see that I can cross simplify, then become a 1 and a 2, that becomes pi over 6. So you should know that 1/12 and 1/6 of something, they're all bigger than 0, but they're less than a pi over 2. So those would be my solutions. Number 2 is a cosine function. This 1/8 times s, that's going to be like your period change. You're trying to isolate this cosine by itself. So we'll add square root of 3 over and divide by 2. So that makes cosine of 1/8 s equal positive square root of 3 over 2. Should work if you need to. And then so I'm trying to figure out where is cosine square root of 3 over 2 positive. So it would put us in quadrants 1 and 4. That would be here at 30 degrees, which is a pi over 6. So we want to take 1/8 s, set it equal to pi over 6, and set it equal to 11 pi over 6. Okay, to get rid of the 1/8, we're going to multiply by 8. I need to reduce my 8 and my 6, divide by 2, that'd be a 4/3. So s is 4 pi over 3, divide by 2, that would be 44 pi over 3. And I just want to show you 44 divided by 3 is 14 point something times pi. So see how that's still smaller than 16 pi. On this level 2, you won't have to worry about really this, other than just understanding it changes because of the period change in our equations. But on the next level, they get even harder. Number 3, these are our reciprocal functions, so it's still doing the same thing. This is a cosecant of 8 pi times x. We'll want to get it by itself by adding 1 over. Okay, remember with cosecant, I want to change it to sine. So we're really saying sine of what angle gives me 1? So where is the y value of 1? That only happens at one spot. It's up here at a 90, which is a pi over 2. And I should say, too, I can't reciprocate 1, right? So that's why sine still stayed 1, because 1 over 1 is still reciprocal of 1. And so really, I'm substituting or setting these equal to each other to solve. So 8 pi times x needs to equal pi over 2. So we got to figure out what x should be. We're going to divide by 8 pi. And I can't do that over here. So dividing by 8 pi is the same thing as multiplying 1 over 8 pi. Pi's cancel. I get 1/16. And that is the only answer I can get. So basically saying if I were to check my answer, I would plug in 1/16 for x. 8 pi times 1/16 is a 1 over 2, a pi over 2, is cosecant at pi over 2 equal to 1? Yes, because it would be where y is 1. So they still check out. And then number 4, cotangent of 5 pi over 4 times x. We're trying to get this by itself, so we divide by square root of 3. Oh, not cosine. And so that'd be 1 over square roots of 3. I would reciprocate that and say, okay, tangent of what angle gives me square root of 3? That's here at a 60. So it's here, and it's also here. So pi over 3 and 4 pi over 3. And it needs to be set equal to the 5 pi over 4 times x to solve. Okay, so to get rid of this 5 pi over 4, I'm going to multiply by its reciprocal, 4 over 5 pi. Pi's are going to cancel. That's all I can do. So I get x to be 4/15. And I get x to be 16/15. Which are all going to be less than 8/5. And that's it.